Way back when I was just a kid, I remember going up to my dad and saying, "Dad, I want to grow up and I want to be a drummer." He turned around to me and said, "Son, you're going to have to choose one or the other. You can't do both." Woodstock, or were you too straight to remember? Here's a real pisser. I'm sitting on the beach in Nantucket with my good buddy Nick Farantella, the very first day of Woodstock weekend. I had just come back from New York, where Felix and Leslie were rehearsing a song for Mountain's Woodstock performance. They were known as Leslie West Mountain at the time. They were going to play Who Am I But You and the Sun, which had been written originally by my band Energy, with Gary Shipp and George Gardos. Felix, who had been producing Energy, loved the song. I was thrilled that they had chosen one of our tunes and felt I was at least going to be at Woodstock spiritually. While in New York the week before, Felix asked me if I'd like to do him a favor, check on some new drum sets at Manny's place and get him some info. I had no idea what he was talking about. Fast forward to December 1969. Enter naive Corky, Canadian-born, totally impressed by everything Laing. There I was at the record plant, still hoping to be at Woodstock, even though Woodstock had been in August earlier that year. I was commissioned by the band 10 years after to put drums on their live Woodstock version of Going Home. All 22 minutes of it. The drum microphones for Rick Lee, the original drummer, had broken down during the performance at Woodstock, and the drums were missing from the live track. As history will note, this song became the hit on the Woodstock album. It immediately went to gold in the summer of 1970. Let me tell you, it was hard to keep time with Alvin Lee on Going Home. Probably some of my most ambitious drumming I ever did, except for the months I played with Meatloaf. The song was over 20 minutes long and was like following a runaway train that had PMS. In the end, though, I received a gold record for playing with 10 Years After and another gold record for Mountain's version of Yasker's Farm, the title of which had been changed from Who Am I But You and the Sun. So finally, here I was. I got two gold records from Woodstock, and I wasn't even there.